Hello everyone, this video is making only for the sake of demo purpose, and the students, those who are willing to write or attempt an exam, national qualifier test, which was conducted by the TCS IT company. So the registration process will goes like this. First, we have to open the link with learning.tcsionhub.in/hub/national-qualifier-test/. Once we click on this link, or if you type in the web browser, it will be opened a window like this. Then in the left side, you can able to see the dates of the when the test is going to be held. Then under this, we can able to see the register now option. So, and the sample test option, this will be activated only in the date of 30th September 2020. So here we need to click the option on register now. Once we click on this button register now, we can able to see a window which have with the name, female ID and password. So as we are very new to this website or this national qualifier test account, we need to create an account under this TCS Ion Digital Learning Hub. So for that, we need to click first create account. Once we click on the create account, a new window which is opened with the necessary details or the details that is to be filled, personal details. Okay. First, we need to fill the full name, email ID, password, which is the same password has to be typed here, and the phone number. After typing the phone number, we have to validate the phone number validating the phone number with the OTP received from us. Then we have to select the age specification, as most of them are graduating students who are in the year final year. Most of them are applying for this national qualifier test. So all are maybe major. So if you are major, so it is asking a question that are you a minor? So all of them who are pursuing a BTech, they mostly in major. So not to touch this button. So make this button as it is. Then followed by make sure some CAPTCHA has been measured. It's been mentioned here, you have to type here, then followed by click a checkbox. By creating your account, you can accept the terms and conditions mentioned by TCS Ion. So let's type all this information shown here. Here, if you see, after entering your full name, then followed by the respective mail ID, then we have to mention our password. Your respective profile password must be a numerical character, a special character, and one uppercase, one lowercase letters. So the same password has to be mentioned here. Okay. After entering the same password under confirm password section, then enter your mobile number, then validate it by receiving an OTP. After receiving OTP, you have to validate it by clicking the OTP. Then it shows that it is a OTP is verified. Then after that, you have to select you have to type the characters which is mentioned under CAPTCHA. Then by clicking it, the button, the checkbox, which is mentioned here. So after typing the letters or the alphabets, which is shown in this image, type as it is, then select the checkbox by creating your account. And we have to accept the terms and conditions or the privacy policy mentioned here. And then you have to click this checkbox once again. I have read all the agreed and understood. Then click the necessary policy, privacy policy mentioned here. Then here one more checkbox. Then the last terms of use, here one more checkbox. for each type, for each section, policy notice, policy privacy policy, terms and use, terms of use, all three sections we have to select the checkbox, then click OK. Then we have the option, highlighted option, to create our account. Then click here for creating an account. Now it shows the option that your name, respective name. So as this is a demo session, so we have been created some name default. So here the last name, first name, which shows by default. Then it shows a note that the details you enter here will be used to generate your certificates. So you will not be able to them post account creation. That's once you have been created your account with the respective name, last name and first name, then you are not able to change your name. So once you have been qualified in the national qualifier test, then you will be secured a certificate. So where with the respective name, which is mentioned here, that the last name and first name. So select the names, choose it properly. Then select the state that you belongs to, which state. So I'm selecting here, Andhra Pradesh. Then I click on the button, continue. Okay. After that, then by default, the website will be redirecting to a new page by clicking on the continue button. Then we are going to see some details, personal details, which we already been entered in the registration by in the creating account section. So the same details will be shown here. So which is not in a not editable manner, which is by default it shows. Then you have to select your date of birth. After selecting the date of birth, then select residing state. So select residing state, which state you belongs to. Then select the residing city. Okay, which city you belongs to. Then once again, you have to generate OTP, which is required in order to validate. Cell type the necessary letters, which is mentioned here. Then submit. Now, once again, we will be receiving an OTP, which is related to our contact number or the mobile number, which is mentioned in the site. After entering the necessary OTP which we have received, then click validate. Then it shows the indication that or notification OTP has been successfully validated. Then click OK. Then now your mobile number has been validated. Then select the graduation which you belongs to. If you are belongs to a bachelor's degree, then select bachelor's degree. It is a Bachelor of Technology. Bachelor of Technology, BTech. Then select graduation branch. You belongs to electrical or mechanical or civil or electronics or computer science. Select the respective branch you belongs to. After that, in which year you are going to complete your graduation. Estimated graduation, if you are attempting from the present final years, then select the necessary year 2021. After that, 2021, select the month. Most probably all the academic years will close by April or May. So you can select any of this month. Then institute name you have to mention, or you can search from the institute name by selecting the institute state and the city that you belongs to. Select the city. And you can mention here the respective name. then click search button. So as in the search history, it is showing that choose at least one search criteria. So select the respective state and the city. Then it shows the respective name of the colleges which is listed under the TCS website. So if the college name is not mentioned, then select the other option, then click that respective option. Okay, then by default it shows the other option. Then enter your respective institute name here. After entering the institute name in this section, then go to examination details. Here you need to take care of selecting what type of mode of exam that you are going to attempt for NQT. Here we need to go first, two options is there. One option is online, remotely proctored. Remotely proctored in the sense the location is preferable to you. You can write it from your home also, and the respective location where you are residing, you can write it from there. So the instructions for the remotely proctored is you need to take care the assessment allows to appear for the test from the home or any location. You can read these points that remotely proctored means that your exam will be monitored by an invigilator remotely. You need to ensure the following system requirements are met. These are mandatory requirements. Windows or Ubuntu OS is mandatory. Google Chrome browser is mandatory, and minimum 2 Mbps internet connectivity and a working webcam is mandatory. These are the minimum must and should requirements if the exam is attempting remotely proctored. Or if you want to write any in-center, TCS Ion Center specifically, then you can select the respective preference state, then followed by the city. Okay, here you can select the respective city. Then after selecting the mode of exam, then you need to upload your photograph. Select the button, click here to upload. Here it shows the option to select the photograph. You can say select from your system or the any Windows. Once the photo has been uploaded, then it shows that the file uploaded successfully. Make sure before uploading the photo, that is a passport size photograph, make sure it should be size met the requirements given by the TCS website. Please upload your recent passport size photograph with a maximum of 1 MB size, and it should be a format of capital JPEG format or capital JPG formats only. You can drop here the photo, or you can select by clicking the browse button from your system or the desktop. Then click close. Then your photo will be uploaded here. After uploading the photograph, then you will be looking here the subject, fourth section, subject NQT test. So TCS and many other IT companies mandate programming skills as a part of eligibility criterion in their selection process. Without this subject NQT programming score, you will not be able to apply for jobs with the TCS and other IT companies. So do you want to apply for this exam also? Means that is most of the students might be from different branches, not only the programming branches, like to see civil, mechanical or any other branches also might be apply for this NQT test. So in this regard, it is better to select all the students that programming is mandatory. Then you select by default, it will be in S. Okay, so make sure don't click as it is a no, it should be as S. Okay, make sure the students, your test subject has to be select S. Then only it is a checkbox is in tick mode, otherwise it is in off mode. Make sure your subject must be selected with S. For this duration is 1 hour. After this, then type your necessary image that is mentioned top. Then after that, you select the checkbox for the declaration, then click on submit. whatever the information that we have entered, it has been shown in the form of a display. Now it is a make sure that there is an application form registration number for each and every individual student. After completion of the declaration, then clicking on the submit, we will be receiving an application form number for NQT alone. Make sure that you need to make it as a reference note by noting down this NQT number somewhere else. Okay, make it as a further communications, and you will be looking an image or the notification. Your application form with the necessary number has been submitted successfully. Then all your login credentials will be receiving for online remotely or any other thing or a hall ticket in the mail ID you have given in the registration form 2 days prior to the date of exam. So make sure, so your mail ID, everything that is mentioned, it should be in a correct manner. And you have to note down your NQT application form number with further reference somewhere else. Then click on the close button. Then you will be viewed with the registration, NQT registration number, first name, last name, and the education, I mean your personal profile details, then followed by educational qualification details, then followed by examination details, okay, whatever you have been mentioned, and your photograph, then subject NQT test, then the duration after the programming, additional details, whatever we have been mentioned, all these been shown here. Then you click the button which is shown at the bottom with the close indication. Click that close button. Then after completing all these details, we can able to see in the left side of the screen with the indication with view details. Before starting of this registration process for NQT application number, we have been viewed with registration now. So instead of registration now, this icon has been changed to view details icon. It is a mandatory. It shows that all our details has been filled up. If we click that view details, we are going to view our application, whatever we have been filled up. This is what the details that we filled up. So if this is, then click close. After completing this, it is, if you want to apply for the exam, we need to go for other website. Once we are done with this registration process, after receiving the NQT application form number, then go to the Google search, then search for the site that is tcsnextstep.com. Then click this, or by default you can enter this link, that is the nextstep.tcs.com/campus/as/. Then by default you will be receiving the window like this. You will be receiving a window like this. Here on the top right side, click the login button. Here you need to enter your DT number. Here you need to enter your DT number, then followed by the necessary password which you already registered with the TCS Next Step. Then click on the login button. So you can able to see a left side panel with the different options, that application form PDF. So if you click the application form PDF, it has to show that download application form which you have been already filled all your details, starting from your personal details to all educational details, academic details. Okay, it has to be completed before applying for the NQT test. Okay, so then only we can able to get the option that apply for drive. Otherwise we won't get the option apply for that. Once we are done with the application, we need to already long back all the students might be filled this form of TCS Next Step, so it has to show the option download application form. Then If it is there, then you will be getting an option on the left side of this panel of the TCS NextStep site, apply for the drive. So click this apply for drive. Here, already by default, it shows some instructions. So these steps we already completed. So register NQT that we already registered, and we have the NQT registration number. So that is to be entered here. After entering the NQT number, registration number, make sure you have to select your nearest TCS office. By default, it will be there, whatever the site is that you have been selected previously. So then enter the NQT registration number, then, and make sure that don't click this link, because already we have been registered for the NQT. So no need to click this link. Then click on apply button. Then it shows that select office, please wait. So already it has been selected. Sorry, I mentioned wrongly. So here, as it is not a test center, it is a TCS office. So here you need to select the nearest office to this. So click here to select the nearest TCS office. Once you click on, it shows the locations where the TCS office exists. So select the nearest TCS office, then select the respective city, then click on OK. Okay. Now, however, the NQT registration number were already mentioned here. Then click for apply. Then it shows a message that you have applied for the recruitment drive. Make sure that if you face any technical problems while you are applying for the National Qualifier Test Registration, if there is any by default, it has been struck or it has been stopped in between, make sure you can just log in to this website by clicking your respective login which has been created. Then once again, you start continuing the procedure where you have been stopped. Okay. Then after that, in this like that is in TCS next step process, that we have been checked for apply for drive section, it shows a message that you have applied for recruitment drive. Okay, once it is done, make sure that you have been successfully applied for the NQT drive. Once it is done, then click on logout. So there is a small message or indication that after completing of the NQT registration process, you will be receive a confirmation mail. Make sure you can note down from your mail also the reference number for the NQT application form number, and even the OTP for the, while you're registering for the NQT application form, even the OTP also will be receiving for your mail IDs. So make sure before at the time of applying, make sure to receive the OTP or the email OTPs. Make sure the connectivity should be there. Thank you.